Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. And welcome to this live broadcast coming to you from St. Peter's Square in Italy on this beautiful Sunday in Rome. It's about 12 o'clock local time, and we're waiting for the Holy Father to appear at that window that you're now seeing on the screen. He will provide a message for us this Sunday, the 16th Sunday of Ordinary Time, and we'll pray the Angelus with him. Before that, I'd like to introduce myself and Francesca Merlo, who's joining me today. Of course, I'm Sister Bernadette, and it is our pleasure to provide the English language texts and commentary for you today. We know that all of you are joining us from all around the world and at different times, the morning, perhaps the afternoon, evening, or even night. Welcome to all of you joining us. Some of you joining us through our own Vatican media channels, perhaps through our Vatican Audio Live Events app, the Vatican Radio app. Some of you tuning in through our Vatican News web portal, our YouTube channel, or perhaps our Facebook Live feed. But we also have other media partners bringing this broadcast to you. We know some of you are tuning in through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks, Salt and Light TV, EWTN, Shalom TV, at Medarshan TV, and among our radio listeners, some tuning in through Radio Maria in England and others through Luminous Radio, and many more of you through other shortwave radio stations picking up the broadcast, as well as other local diocesan stations. The Holy Father has been taking some downtime. He has not been meeting with as many groups as he normally does. However, one of the major things that he did this past week is to appoint three women. It's the first time in history, as members of the dicastery for bishops. Two of them are women religious, one works inside the Vatican, and one is the head of a worldwide organization for Catholic women who belongs to an organization for consecrated virgins. Our Holy Father is also getting ready to go on his trip that starts next week in Canada. He'll be going there, be meeting first leg to Edmonton in Canada, and then on to the East Coast in Quebec. And of course, Vatican News will be covering all of that, both on our website as well as through our social media channels. Here we see the crowds, and our Holy Father has now appeared at the window.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno, good morning. The Gospel of this Sunday's liturgy presents us with a lively domestic scene with Martha and Mary, two sisters who extend their hospitality to Jesus in their home. Martha immediately sets about welcoming the guests, whereas Mary sits at Jesus' feet to listen to him. So Martha turns to the Master and asks him to tell Mary to help her. Martha's complaint does not seem out of place. On the other hand, we feel we agree with her. Yet Jesus answers her, "Martha, Martha, you are worried and distracted by many things, but few things are needed. Mary has chosen the better part, which will not be taken away from her." This is a surprising answer, but Jesus many times overturns our way of thinking. Let us ask ourselves then, why the Lord, while appreciating Martha's generous care, says that Mary's attitude is to be preferred? Martha's philosophy seems to be this: first duty, then pleasure. In fact, hospitality is not made of fine words, but demands that one turns one hand to the stove, that one does everything necessary for the guest to feel welcome. Jesus is well aware of this, and indeed he acknowledges Martha's effort. However, he wants to make her understand that there is a new order of priorities, different from the one she had followed until then. Mary had sensed that there is a better part that must be given first place. Everything else comes after, like a stream flowing from the spring. And so we ask ourselves, what is this better part? It is the listening of Jesus' words. The Gospel says Mary sat at Jesus' feet and listened to what he was saying. Note, though, she did not listen while standing, doing other things, but she sat at Jesus' feet. She understood that he is not like other guests. At first sight, it seems that he has come to receive, because he needs food and lodging. In reality, the Master has come to give himself to us through his word. The word of Jesus is not abstract. It is a teaching that touches and shapes life, changes it, frees it from the dullness of evil, satisfies and infuses it with a joy that does not pass. It is the better part. Therefore, Mary gives it first place. She stops and listens. The rest will come after. This does not detract from the value of practical effort, but it must not precede, but rather flow from listening to the word of Jesus. It must be enlivened by his spirit. Otherwise, it is reduced to fussing and fretting over many things to sterile activism.
Fratelli e sorelle,
brothers and sisters, let us take advantage of this holiday season to stop and listen to Jesus. Nowadays, it is increasingly difficult to find free time to meditate. For many people, the rhythms of life and frenetic work are wearisome. The summer period can be valuable also for opening the Gospel and reading it slowly, without haste. Every day a small passage. This helps us enter the dynamic of Jesus. Let us allow ourselves to be challenged by those pages, asking ourselves how our life is going, if it is in line with what Jesus says. In particular, let us ask ourselves, when I start my day, do I throw myself headlong into the things to be done, or do I first seek inspiration in the Word of God? At times we begin our days automatically, doing things, whereas first we must look at the Lord and take his word as our inspiration to start the day. If we leave the house in the morning with a word of Jesus in mind, the day will acquire a tone marked by that word, which has the power to direct our actions according to the wishes of the Lord. May the Virgin Mary teach us to choose the better part, which will never be taken from us.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est,
et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitri.
Ut digne ficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam Tua, in quaesum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut qui angelo annunciante, Christi Fili Tui, incarnazione coniovimus, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamur. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce Deis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunquet usque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, yesterday in Germany, John Philip Jengingen was beatified. He was a member of the Society of Jesus. He lived in Germany in the second half of the 17th century, and he ministered among the people in Gutenberg. He was an untiring proclaimer of the gospel in every social class, enlivened by a great apostolic spirit and a special Marian devotion. May his example and intercession of this priest help us to feel the joy of sharing the gospel with our brothers and sisters. Let's give a round of applause to the newly beatified. I express again my closeness to the people of Sri Lanka. Dear brothers and sisters, I join you in prayer, and I exhort all parties to seek a peaceful solution to the present crisis in favor of the, in particular, of the most poor, respecting everyone's rights. I join the religious leaders to abstain from any form of violence and to begin a process of dialogue for the common good. And I am always near to the battered Ukrainian people, hit every day by a rain of missiles. How is it possible that people can understand that war only creates destruction and distances the possibility for dialogue? I pray and I hope that all international leaders do everything in order to pick up negotiations once again, instead of increasing those made homeless by the war. Next Sunday, I will depart for Canada. I want to speak to all the people of that country. Dear brothers and sisters of Canada, as you know, I will come to you above all in the name of Jesus in order to draw near and embrace the indigenous populations. Unfortunately, Many Christians, including members of religious institutes, cooperated with the assimilation, which greatly wounded in many ways the indigenous communities. And because of this, I recently received a few groups in the Vatican that represented the indigenous populations, to whom I manifested my own sorrow and solidarity for the wounds that they received. And so now I am entering into a penitential pilgrimage, which I hope, with God's grace, might contribute to the journey of healing and reconciliation, which has already been begun. I thank you up until now for all of the work, the preparatory work, and for the welcome that you will be giving to me. Thank you to you all, and I ask all of you to accompany me in prayer. And now I greet all of you, dear people of Rome and pilgrims, especially the Sisters of the Resurrection and the Missionaries of the Sacred Heart, who their general chapters are taking place here in Rome. I greet the faithful. He's greeting a group that has come from Spain, Seville in Spain, and the young people who are following a course of formation among Regnum Christi, the group. These young people are making themselves heard. I would like also to return the greeting of the young people who greeted me from the Gifoni Film Festival, especially to those who are disadvantaged and placed at the margins of society. And I also greet the people from the Immaculata. And to all of you, I wish you a blessed Sunday. Please do not forget to pray for me. And he closes with his signature, enjoy your meal and arrivederci. We'll see each other again. And this now brings to an end the live broadcast of the Angelus message and prayer with Pope Francis here in St. Peter's Square on this 16th Sunday of Ordinary Time. I invite you to visit the Vatican News web portal, our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts, where you'll find coverage of today's Angelus as well as other Vatican and world news. On behalf of Vatican Media, I'd like to thank Alessandro Carucci, our audio technician, and Alessandro Di Carolis, our coordinator, who've made this broadcast possible. And once again, our media partners, Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Network, Salt and Light TV, EWTN, Radio Maria in England, Shalom TV at Madarshan TV, and Luminous Radio. And as I said, you'll be able to follow all of the Pope's trip to Canada. You'll also find that on our Vatican News website. Thank you all for joining us today, and have a most blessed remainder of this Sunday. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ.